No Japanese info by Japanese people. Then, count on me! Hey there, I'm Naoto. Today's episode concerns the three sacred treasures in Japan, which is inevitable to talk about when it comes to Japanese history. Japan is known as a somewhat unique country in terms of its long-standing history. I am proud to say there has been consistently the existence of emperor at the top of Lulla from 2,000 years ago. And when it comes to imperial succession, there are always the three sacred treasures in Japan, on the ground that these treasures are said to be received from gods, and they are primarily needed for the imperial succession. But these imperial regalia, per se, are filled with mysteries. There are tons of things unknown. The people out there are strictly prohibited to have an audience with treasures. In other words, nobody, at least nobody living today, had seen the three treasures, and that's even applied to emperor. On the other hand, there are many rumors about the three treasures, including its relation with Jewish. So, today on the Japanalist, let's explore the hidden side of the three treasures. According to the oldest Japanese literature, Nihon Shoki, there are Yata no Kagami, Kusanagi no Tsurugi, and Yasakani no Magatama. In other words, there are, so to speak, a mirror of Yata, a sword of Kusanagi, and a Magatama of Yasakani. They are actually said to be secured in different places, but you can't see them, even if you visit the places like Isejingu Shrine. Now, let's see one by one. First of all, Yata no Kagami, a mirror of Yata. Yata no Kagami represents wisdom in imperial rituals. According to Japanese myth, it is very well known among Japanese that the sun goddess Amaterasu shut herself in Ama no Iwato, which appears to be a huge cave. Amaterasu represents sun. So, consequently, the world was thrown into darkness because Amaterasu is away. In response, other gods discussed how they can induce Amaterasu to come outside the cave. Then a god, Omoikane, came up with the idea to produce a mirror. And this is said to be Yata no Kagami, a mirror of Yata. But how they used a mirror to induce Amaterasu to come outside? Many gods got gathered and held a lively festival in front of Ama no Iwato, a cave where Amaterasu was shutting herself. Amaterasu wondered what was happening out there. She tried to take a peek out through a crack. Then she realized there's a mirror in front of the crack. She saw herself on the mirror and got flinched in the moment, and Amaterasu came outside of Ama no Iwato. Second of all, let's see Kusanagi no Tsurugi, a sword of Kusanagi, which represents valor, or I can say courage. This sword is said to be enshrined at Atsutajingu Shrine in Aichi Prefecture. Just like Yata no Kagami, Kusanagi no Tsurugi also has a relation to Japanese myth. A god, Susanoo, who is actually a brother of Amaterasu, was asked to slay a gigantic snake called Yamata no Orochi, which was doing people tremendous harm. Susanoo successfully defeated Yamata no Orochi, and one theory holds that it was then that Kusanagi no Tsurugi was found from inside the body of Yamata no Orochi and taken away by Susanoo. And third of all, Yasakani no Magatama, which is the only one regalia secured at Imperial Palace today. This Magatama represents benevolence. But well, I think many of you are unfamiliar with Magatama in the first place. Magatama is a kind of accessory in ancient time, and Magatama is said to be used in rituals, but most of the things about it are not uncovered yet. Yasakani no Magatama is the only one of the three regalias which is said to be an original. Do you know what I mean? Affected by some historical incidents, the three regalias suffered from battles and fires many times. According to a record, the imperial palace of the time burned out in 1005 and 1040, and correspondingly, the three regalias were damaged by fire. And it is said the mirror of Yata was also burned away or at least lost due to the fire. In addition, as for the sword of Kusanagi, it was said to be lost in a battle. In 1185, there was a battle of Dannora in which samurai clan Genji fought against Heishi. Heishi took the three regalias away from the imperial palace, and the Battle of Danura took place on the ocean. As a result, Genji defeated Heishi. However, the three regalias were sunk in the ocean, together with Antoku Emperor holding regalias. Genji tried so hard to find out these three regalias. Unfortunately, they could get the mirror and the Magatama back on the ground. But despite of their best effort, the sword of Kusanagi wind up with being lost. On the other hand, there are said to be many replicas of the three treasures. And some say the sword of Kusanagi sunk in the ocean was just a replica. The original one, in contrast, was safely enshrined at Atsuta-jingu Shrine, so it was no problem that Genji could not find out the sword from the ocean. The same can be applied to the others. Well, there was a fire, but the original regalias were safe. We are not sure whether it is true, but one thing I can say is the worst scenario is as follows. There is no original treasure, the mirror and the Magatama was burned away, and the sword was sunk into the ocean, and here they are, we have splendid replicas. But we are never allowed to see them. In the end, I'd like to introduce one interesting theory about the relation to Jewish. Yet, for making sure, I would say it's just a theory, which is not fully backed up by historical evidences. Here is an interesting story about the mirror of Yata. There are some testimonies that there are Hebrew letters on the backside of the mirror. Back in Meiji period from 1868, where Japan transformed itself from samurai history, Meiji Emperor, together with some bureaucrats, took an audience to Yata no Kagami, which became the last time of the audience in history. According to a testimony by a bureaucrat of the time, Mori Arinori, there's a following Hebrew letters on the mirror. I'm not sure whether I correctly pronounce. Well, frankly, I cannot read it. But so far as I investigated, it means I am that I am. In any case, since then, Meiji Emperor strictly prohibited to see the mirror anymore. He said, we, including our descendants down the road, should never take a look at the mirror. The reason for that is unknown. We are not sure if there are Hebrew letters, or perhaps the mirror per se is burned away, nothing remains today, or even there's another mystery tucked away. Who knows? The three regalias are still remaining as a mystery in Japan. But without doubt, they are a very important item for us Japanese people. Thanks for watching. See you next time on the Japanalist.